Hello everyone and welcome to the Mike from LA1 Network here on YouTube and welcome back to the Daniel Bryan My Career Series here in NBA 2K13. And boy, Daniel is screwed. Because, well, take a look who their next opponent is. Yes, it's the 6-2 Oklahoma City Thunder at Oklahoma City. So yeah, they are completely screwed. Daniel is the shooting guard of the Memphis Grizzlies, which right now they are 1-5, but he decided to keep Jerry Lawler happy by staying put in Memphis, Tennessee. As you can see right now, yes, boy, he is screwed from the start, because take a look who's their guy. It's none other than he's going to be in really big trouble against Oklahoma City. As you can see right now, as we are at the Chesapeake Energy Arena, even though the Jumbotron clearly says Oklahoma City Arena. Are you serious, bro? And right now, if Daniel does decide to demand a trade, which I can't blame him for it, but I don't see that happening yet. So here we go, it's Oklahoma City. And let's get this update now from Doris. And there's Connolly. He's going to lose the ball. And it goes out of bounds and the Thunder gets the ball. So this may not be good. So here we go. As Daniel gets back to go to Memphis. There's Lamont. Barely got him there, but oh well. So here we go, Connolly. He's going to try and go for the shot here, but it's not enough time. Daniel tries to call it, but he's ignored. Gives it to Rudy Gay. Now with the Toronto Raptors. And here's Connolly. Connolly gives it back to Rudy Gay. Gay's going for the jumper, and he does get it. And the Grizzlies are back in this thing. So here goes, here's the Durantula, who is one of the co-covers of this game, other with Derrick Rose and Blake Griffin. And boy, Kobe had some choice words to Ibaka, who hit Blake Griffin in the groin. Ouch. And boy, he would have punched him in the mouth. And boy, I can't blame him. And uh-oh, and that was a bad shot by Daniel, and there's Lamon. Ooh, thank you, Rudy. Thank you. Because Daniel's teammate, Ray, would have went down even more if he wasn't paying attention. And there you see Daniel's going to take the shot, and guess what? His teammate, Ray, goes down once again. Oh, boy. So this is the last video for tonight, because I have to take a rest after the awesomeness that was Monday Night Raw. But chances are, because we are expecting rain in the forecast tomorrow, and ooh, and another block shot. So that's the end of the first quarter with the score. The Thunder are leading the Memphis Grizzlies 23-18. So it's time for the quick advertisement.
Tune in next Sunday night
for November 18th.
Warriors on Kevin Durant and the Oklahoma City Thunder.
Ooh. And right now, Daniel did tweet out this thing, and I quote, but not the real Daniel Bryan. He clearly said he's gonna take the time off he needs to look at the because I want to see him go to somewhere nice to end his career, but not right now. So here we go, as it's now 46-33. And right now, and there you see Daniel Bryan. Daniel trying to make it through to these guys, but nope, he's going to pass it to the Bayless, and he does get a pass leading to foul, almost an assist, but he gives us a game tip. Let's read it. Yeah, you guys don't want to read that. So 9.5 seconds left. There's the free throw, and he makes it, and so at the end of the first half, the Thunder leading the Grizzlies 48-37. And, oh, he bumped the ref. Technical foul. Oh, wait, the buzzer already sounded. Oh, I missed.
It's Wednesday night at the 2K Sports.
Yeah. I did not read who the leading scorer was. And there you see Stampede, or whatever that thing's name is. As Daniel does get back out there with 63-49. Don't forget, as you can see, as right now, as you can see it, ooh, Daniel nearly got, and Daniel took off. He drew the foul there, which I was kind of surprised at that. And Daniel got sent to the bench once again, and he doesn't get back in there till the fourth quarter. I was kind of expecting him to get benched for the rest of the game there because of the team's poor performance, but nope, the team is within 10. They are fighting this, fighting back. But Daniel's getting no points whatsoever, so I think maybe it might be time for him, Daniel, to get you, go. Does allow him to score and spark the run. That's the next one, and he called a timeout by accident. That was a bit embarrassing. So there's Daniel Bryant, at least score it too. There he goes. Does make the selection. He gets an opportunity at the end one, which, knowing my characters in this game, you know what that means. No, he made it! I was quite surprised. He actually made it, and there's a milestone right there, folks. He converted the and one. There's Kendrick Perkins. And there's Daniel Bryant, and again he tried it, but again he missed. So here we go, a minute 45 left, and there you see, and there's another missed shot. And there you see Marc Gasol. And there's Shorty. I can't believe I can't. Yeah, why not? And reaching call right there. So here we go, as Daniel Bryant, and there's another timeout right there, as. So there's Daniel Bryant trying to make it through Oklahoma's defense, but he decides to pass it to Rudy Gay, and there's an assist right there. First one of the evening, and the first one of the episode, and let's see what time it is. 9:40, oh boy. I might be in trouble. I hope you guys enjoyed the Alita episode earlier this morning. This afternoon, I do apologize. Oh, I missed. And he gives it to Conley. And I'm surprised he didn't take the shot. But he gives it to Marc Gasol. So a minute two left. So I'm not going to be surprised if he has to be tasked to take a seat. No, he didn't get asked to take a seat. I'm quite surprised. There's Perkins, well, nearly blocked him, but he allowed him to score. So his teammate Ray takes a small hit. And there you see Daniel, he gets the ball again. And there you see, nope, he missed once again. Ooh! Daniel got sneaky. Yes. And he called a timeout for some reason. And he gives it to Bayless, who gives it to Spites. And there's Bayless, and again he gets it in, and they are going to come close. But in the end, it's going to be another loss. Going to be yet another loss for the Memphis Grizzlies, but they lose by 8 points, but not a bad performance by Daniel Bryant nonetheless. But as you can see, he only got 3 skill points because, well, he for that highlight play. which was his first and one in the NBA. Player of the game, I think, is Kevin Durant, and I'm absolutely right. So now it's time to go to the press conference.
We've certainly seen bigger games from you out there. In fact, I'd even say you looked a little complacent at times tonight. Any response?
You know what? In honor of The Rock, why not?
Whatever. It doesn't matter to me what you think. Until you're in my head helping me to decide what to do on the court, then you have no idea about something like that. In fact, it's ridiculous for you to even think that you might know. Next game, I'm sure I'll play a little better. But to start throwing out words like complacent after one off game, that's crazy talk, man.
In other words, that reporter was winning. Yeah, I gotta throw a Charlie Sheen joke in there. Okay, so on to the next game. And yes, I like to call these. On to the next game, but before we do, Daniel wants to talk to the GM. Which, I love this feature in this game. And right now, we are counting down the hours to MLB 2K13, which I'm not going to get it just yet. Hold your horses, people. Undead, his mind got swept away at 18 seconds.
Something I wanted to talk to you about, but it totally slipped my mind, man. I'll let you know when I remember what it was, man. Sorry about that.
I love it when he does that.
No problem. Feel free to drop by when you remember what it was.
Hey, it's Antonio Cesaro. How ironic. Okay, just kidding, people. Well, the reason why he only got 3 skill points was the fact that he committed no turnovers whatsoever. So, on to the next game against the New York Knickerbockers, or the Knicks, 1-6. So at this point, Daniel may want to wish Memphis the best of luck in its future endeavors at this point, because there is no way they're going to make it in this league. There is no way they're going to do it here right now, because right now they got themselves in a huge hole. So on to this game against the Knicks. Oh boy, as Daniel's getting 25% popularity. Oh boy, so he's gonna get booed relentlessly. And don't worry, we're gonna talk about the teammate grade situation popularity later. And right now it is 15-10. So we're back at home. To face this Knicks team. As you can see, right now things are not looking good. Daniel called a timeout again, so he's not. He's back in there with 3:58 left to go, back in as the shooting guard, as the Grizzlies are down by 7. But they are still in contention. There you see Conley going to give it to deep Daniel Bryant. And we're going to do the social media for this both games tomorrow afternoon, once I'm done with class. So here we go, Daniel Bryant going to give it to Conley. He gets blocked. There's Poindexter. And ooh, he lost the ball and he commits a turnover. But take a look at this. Have you ever seen goats fly? Well, he doesn't get a good. Oh, yeah, he does. So he got most of that back. So here you go. Here's Daniel Bryan trying to get through as, but he decides to give it to, is that Poindexter? And is he going to get assist? No. Timeout. Oh, because of, ooh, didn't get Jason Kidd, but doesn't get the good shot defense there. Game. So here's Daniel Bryan. And there you see Daniel, and he gets a bad shot deflection. Selection. Oh, I missed. Uh-oh. Don't get a good. Don't get it. And, ooh, well, he allowed him to score. Ouch. So bring with the gap down to 5. I don't see that happening. So here we go. Daniel Bryan gets the ball again. Can he somehow spark this team? But he gives it to Zach Randolph, and there's the assist. So that could be that spark that they are talking about. So here we go. There's Gasol, and he misses. Nice job. So here we go. There's Shumpert. Ooh, good dunk there by Shumpert.
They have the players to get it done, so we'll see how it plays out. Now
the feed to Gasol. And Daniel's getting completely ignored. And there's a charging foul. Timeout! Second foul of the game. Invalid game screw. And small forward. Jeez.
Number one, Tyson Chandler. Well, he got high percentage looks all last year, and he made the most of them. Catching up on the changes for Memphis. Spates checked in for Gasol. Arthur comes in for Zach Randolph. Wayne Ellington's checked in for Quincy Bondexter. And Jared Bayless subbed in for Mike Conley.
There's Wayne Ellington, gives it to Daniel Bryan, who gives it back to Ellington, and there's a reaching call, and now D. Bryan's now centerman now. And there's Copeland. Wait, is Edge in this game too? Wait, I've got to get back to him. Maybe, you know what, yeah, let's add Edge tomorrow. There's Gang, gives it to Dr. Shelby, and there's a goaltending on James White. That sounded scary.
Well, you knew the Grizzlies were anticipating going deep into the playoffs after they had a nice run for the second round in 2011. They don't seem ready to settle for first round exits.
Now there's a good shot defense on Amari Stoudemire, and he lost it, and he lost it, and lost some more. And here we go. Here goes Dr. Shelby. With Dr. Bell! Dr. Bell! How to do that? Hashtag Dr. Phil!
Anthony's got 6 rebounds in the game.
And here we go, and there's Arthur. Gives it to Rudy Gay. And there's Rudy Gay, and ooh! And now it's an 8-point deficit for the Grizzlies. Ugh, it is. And Daniel paid the price for that. And just like that, at the end of the first half, the Knicks lead the Grizzlies 41-30. And at this point, Daniel might be considering requesting a trade. And there you see Grizz.
Getting back to the action now. It's been a one-team show so far. We'll see if that changes here in the third. Carmelo Anthony really has his fingerprints all over this one.
And a lot of the second chances that this team has gotten have come because of his hard work underneath.
Steve, he's scrapping and fighting and positioning down there and doing everything he can within the rules to get his team extra chances. And I think it's just a credit to his hustle out there.
Court for the Knicks. At the 3, 4, and 5, we've got Carmelo Anthony, Amari Stoudemire, and Tyson Chandler.
Jason Kidd and J.R. Smith manning the backcourt. Chandler's shot.
Good.
Another board for them. And
so here we go, as it's 43-30. Daniel Bryan, the only thing he's done is got that assist by Zach Randolph. And he's getting closer to his first bucket of the evening. And hold on 1 second, I do apologize for that. Quit on pausing, gang, jeez. And Daniel's the point guard? What? He's supposed to be the shooting guard. Yeah, he's clearly a shooting guard. Why is he the point guard?
And a great assist by Kidd as that one goes in.
So here we go as Daniel Bryant trying to get his first bucket, but the Knicks are just too relentless. And he keeps missing. Yeah, my new catchphrase. Gotta love it. And there's Rudy Gay, who's not going to give it to Daniel Bryan. And Rudy Gay. Oh, huge slam dunk there. Brought to you by Sprite. And no, I'm not going to monetize this video. And there's a timeout, and he's moved a power forward.
Making a switch here. Conley's checked in. And it's going to be out of bounds.
Out of bounds.
Grizzlies, you wonder for Stoudemire is some of his explosiveness.
Timeout. There we go. Much better.
A little bit more.
I think he'd be well served to do just that, Kevin, but I don't know if he necessarily will. That first step has been a devastating weapon, and I think he's actually better when he's
able to face. And here goes Daniel, who might be considering he might want to out of Memphis. But right now, at this point, I think the coach might be doing a bad job with this team. So Daniel might be complaining about that.
And the Knicks miss again. The New York Knicks, they come in off the loss to the San Antonio Spurs.
Yeah, I went back and looked at the tape of that game.
And there's Marc Gasol, and there's yet another assist for Daniel. Two assists, oh boy. So, well, at least the assist numbers are there. But not in the scoring department. And, oh, got a good dunk by Amari Stoudemire. So his teammate Gray takes a slight dip again. And by slit, it went down a whole letter grade. And there's Connolly, who gives it to Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan trying to get it in, but in the end, he takes the shot. He does make the basket. There's a good shot defense right there. How about that? So here's Allen, who's the try and gives it to the, and that's a 47-47 lead. So just like that, right now, as the Knicks, they're not okay. Ooh, almost got him there. He almost got the LaBelle dunk there, and timeout! As Daniel's at two guard once again, to Conley. So as right now, as you can see, it's the time check of the clock. It is 9:56. And there's Rudy Gay, and he got ignored, and he missed. And there's Arthur, and he does make the basket. So now the deficit is 9. So here we go. Here goes Daniel trying to get the Daniel, and there he goes, and he's now starting to get hot. Oh, don't you dare, please. Okay. And there you see Carmelo Anthony make that killer slam dunk there. So here we go. Less than a minute to go in the third. There's D&D Bryant. He almost got it. So that was bad. And there's Schrumpert, and that's another bucket for the Knicks.
I can imagine they're going to hear an
earful about this next stop. I mean, that's three straight field goals given up right
in the middle of the lane. Well, Conley gives it to Daniel Bryant. Steve Bryant got that through, and he misses once again. So now he's hitting another cold spell right here. And
Shumpert gets to Smith from 12 feet out. But Grizzlies pull it in.
Now there, your nice pass to Rudy Gay.
This their first look at this year's New York squad.
And there's Rudy Gay, and he makes the bucket.
A year ago, and they had no problem with a winning cold matchup. He's been producing all night. It's up to the rest of his team to start kicking in a little bit.
There's Anthony, and ooh, good. And there's Daniel Bryant. Bryant trying to get a last second shot. No, he gets blocked, and his teammate Gray goes down again. Good teammate stop right there, right there. And here's an advertisement for November 19th. Wow. That's a good competition there. And as you can see, Daniel Bryant is out there once again, and this may not be good for my thing here. And oh, I gotta leave assignment. Shoot. Timeout! So here we go, Daniel Bryan, and oh, he drew the foul. So looks like he's going to the free throw line once again. And they're slightly early, and he missed. And just for that, he gets awarded by being the new power forward. So there's he slightly early, and he loses his teammate. Great. Ooh, so he's about to enter the danger zone. Do. Yeah, sorry for my voice going down deep because it's starting to get very tired here, but I don't know. And here we go. So Daniel might get sent to the bench after this. Hopefully. Nope, he gets moved to center. So
get him the ball, and he'll create something, either an open look, a drive to
so
the
ball, here we go.
Or get himself to the foul line. And that isn't the end of it there either. I mean, even if you stick with Melo and get a hand in his face, a lot of times it doesn't
so
matter.
So here he goes.
Not even bother the way
he there is Ian. Ooh, and he gets the goaltending, and just like that, Daniel Bryan now has 6 points.
Almost got to that shot in time, but not quite. Can't touch the ball once it's on the way down.
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Arthur's checked in. And the Knicks making a change here as well.
And he allowed an inside pass, and he allowed him to score. Now he's in the danger zone. Once again, three strikes, and you're fired. That's just that simple. Three F's, and you're fired. But once they're fired, they lose their current spot. Well, not. And that means Daniel Bryan will make way for a new character. So Rudy Gay. So now Daniel Bray hopefully gets a substitution. Nope.
And I think, guys, we'll never stop talking about that Knicks trade with Denver for Carmelo Anthony. It was such a fascinating deal. Everyone thought the Knicks probably made out the best getting Carmelo. But when you look at Denver, the pieces they were able to add, and that's a pretty intriguing deal.
There's Daniel Bryan, and there's more points, and Daniel's starting to get red hot.
Well done, finishing that one off. Here's Smith.
And, ooh, good dunk right there. No, not, wait, that wasn't a slam dunk. What was that? What am I thinking? So, Conley gives it to Daniel Bryan, trying to get his first 10-point game of his career. He decides to say, 8's good enough. So, Allen loses it to Shumpert, and uh-oh, he's going to try and dunk it. I can tell. No, he's going to go for a jumper, and he missed. So here we go. There's Rudy Gay. Gay gets it, and now the Grizzlies. Timeout! Hold on. What's better? Well, someone called a timeout, but it's not But that wasn't Daniel. Ooh, and his teammate Greg goes down once again. Ugh, yikes. And there's another timeout, and once again, Daniel's still out there, so he could get a F at this point.
Was the Memphis Grizzlies in their last game a loss to Oklahoma City. They came out flat that night and could never really get it going. Not their best effort for sure, Clark.
And there you see a nice, and there's an assist, so he could get out of that danger zone ASAP. And Daniel nearly tripped there, I just noticed there, half hour. So, as that way Shorty, as Jody gives it to Allen, and there's almost another assist, and uh-oh, Daniel Bryan left early. So here goes Daniel, uh-oh, here we go, he jumped early, but he missed, so. Shot there, and there's Rudy Gay, ooh, good. Good dunk right there. Woo!
Denied on that one, no matter what the defender threw at him. Yeah, he needed just a little more effort to make that stop.
So as you can see right now, it is past 10 o'clock West Coast time, so I could save and stop it right here, stop the game right here and save and continue it tomorrow, early tomorrow morning, but I don't want to do that. Trust me, I don't. So here we go, and there's a reaching call right there. So Daniel's back as shooting guard. As right now, as gets robbed for Connolly, and here we go. Connolly gives it to Daniel Bryan. Bryan gives it to Randolph. There's assist number 4. And now 1 minute left. Jeez. And he allowed him to score. So 1 minute left. So there's Daniel Bryan. There's Bryan, and oh, 10 points were right there. But gravity said, so yeah, we not gonna let you do that. And he does, and he makes another bucket. So 71-56, and at this point right now, the game's pretty much over. And right now, the fans in Memphis are probably going to boo Daniel for this one. So a big rebound from the last game. Which, it doesn't matter what you think, it doesn't matter, la, 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 la. What The Rock is cooking. That's also what's kind of funny, that The Rock called Daniel Bryan an Oompa Loompa on Raw 1000. And that's it. Game over. The Grizzlies fall to 1-7. So 1-7. So as Daniel does not get it, he does finish with a D average again. So the player of the game, I'm going to make sure I do it this time. It's Carmelo Anthony as they lose 71-58. Now it's time to go to the press conference for the last time today before we head back to the GM.
Rough game at the line for the team tonight. Obviously, you came out on the losing end, but how much did your poor free throw shooting play into that?
It was probably the reason. We were shooting like we couldn't hit the broadside of a barn tonight. And from the line even? Come on, man. They call them free throws for a reason. We have to take advantage of those kind of situations. There's absolutely no reason a self-respecting NBA player can't hit at least 75%. So when the whole team's just flailing away like we did, we got no chance.
No chance in hell. You got that right. So now Daniel's gonna make some but he did not leave the FedEx Forum right away, people. Oh no. He did not leave there right away. He did not leave the FedEx Forum right away. Instead, after this day saved, he, after the game, fresh from taking a shower at the FedEx Forum, he went straight to the GM's office to file a complaint. And this is a big spoiler alert. Is he going to demand that trade?
I need to really make as big an impact as I'd like to. I'm afraid those kind of decisions are out of my hands. I assemble the roster. Coach decides the minutes.
Well, he's playing favorites. I'm busting my tail out there in games and in practice, but when the game's in the balance, I'm watching. If my game isn't appreciated, maybe I'd be better off somewhere else. What do you think, huh?
Whoa, whoa, take it easy. Look, my only priority, and his only priority, is winning. That's all I can say. Make the most of the minutes you're getting and play for your teammates, not just yourself.
No doubt. All right, well, thank you. And good talk, man. I'll see you later.
But right now, we've got to stay focused on the task at hand, and that's getting the win against the Bobcats.
Oh, that's going to be easy. You're welcome, and good night, everybody, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.